हेलो हेलो एम आई ऑडिबल?
यस मैम।
हेलो सर, नमस्ते। अभिजीत सर नमस्ते। कैसे
नमस्ते नमस्ते। फर्स्ट
हैं सर?
क्लास, बहुत अच्छा। आप सब कैसे हैं?
बस सब बढ़िया सर। शुरू करें सर?
जरूर।
जी सर, सभी लोगों को नमस्कार। 7वें अंतर्राष्ट्रीय योग दिवस के उपलक्ष्य में स्वस्थ वृत्त एवं योग विभाग राष्ट्रीय आयुर्वेद संस्थान जयपुर की तरफ से आयोजित वेबिनार की लेक्चर सीरीज के चौथे लेक्चर में मैं विभागाध्यक्ष डॉक्टर दुर्गावती देवी आप सभी लोगों का बहुत बहुत स्वागत करती हूँ, अभिनंदन करती हूँ। आज के हमारे अतिथि व्याख्यान के अतिथि हैं डॉक्टर अभिजीत कौर जी। ही इज मास्टर्स इन योगा एंड मेडिटेशन एंड पीएचडी इन योगा एंड मेडिटेशन। प्रेजेंटली ही इज डायरेक्टर ऑफ विवेकानंद योग अनुसंधान संस्थान कोलकाता। इट इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ वी व्यासा योगा यूनिवर्सिटी बैंगलोर। ही इज अ स्टेट सेक्रेटरी इंडियन योगा एसोसिएशन वेस्ट बंगाल। He is a state president Arogya Bharati West Bengal. He is a state vice president National Yogasana Sports Federation West Bengal. He is former faculty of S Vyasa Bangalore and Dong Seoul University South Korea. He is a motivational speaker, yoga therapy consultant, corporate yoga expert and leadership trainer. He has so many publications in newspapers and journals nationally and internationally. He has delivered so many talks and research papers in various national and international conferences at various platforms. Now I would like to invite Dr. Abhijit Ghosh sir to deliver his talk on yoga and wellness. Welcome, sir.
Namaste. Mujhe sunai de raha hai? Clear?
Ji sir. Sunai de raha sir.
Okay. First of all, thank you for inviting me to the prestigious Institute of Ayurveda, the Ayurveda National Institute of Ayurveda, Jaipur. I think it is considered one of the best Ayurveda institute in India. As per my knowledge, it may be the Nalanda of Ayurveda in present day. Thank organizer, especially Shalini and other organizers, those who are supporting me, helping me for this program. The theme is yoga and wellness. As I came to know, this program is for all the students of Ayurveda, and those who are interested, they have joined this program. So I will show some slides also. The slides are visible, I think. Do you see the slides? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I make it large so that it should be presentable. Okay. Now it is okay, I think.
Yes, sir.
Now shall I go ahead?
Yes, sir.
Okay. As we are from the field of yoga, and about yoga, there are many misconceptions throughout the world. Mostly, yoga is known by its practices. That also, only yoga practices means yoga acrobats, asanas, and pranayamas. In the West and other countries, they know yoga means yogic postures. Not only abroad, even in India also, if I ask someone about yoga, they will explain in a various way that it is a kind of physical exercise, it's a yoga pose, only asanas. In the remote, if you ask about yogis, they will think, oh, they are the tantrics, they do some jharku, they do some magic, or some breathing juggles. These are the concepts about yoga in India also and throughout the world, obviously. So as those who are students of yoga, they know very well, these are not only the yoga, these are the presentations of yoga in various ways, the reflection of yoga, yogic practices in a different way. So that's what about these practices and postures, people know much more, they are interested, they are fascinated about yoga. And similarly, people started thinking and attracted towards yoga. But yoga is the science of holistic living. Those who know about yoga, those who study about yoga, they know very well that it's all about the holistic living and further. In independent system of knowledge, that is yoga, and it has many scriptures, many philosophical texts, which is available today. So it is featured by peace and poise, health and happiness, knowledge and efficiency, self-control and service zeal, and so on. So yoga is not only bound in the practices of asanas and pranayamas and some other what we see. Yoga is all about way of life. The concept of yoga, in our scripture, it is explained, it is the skill to calm down the mind. In Yoga Vasishtha, and there are many other texts like Patanjali Yoga Sutra, if you go through Bhagavad Gita, these all are yoga texts. They are explaining yoga is to deal with the mind and further. So it is the skill to calm down the mind. Mana prasamana upayaha yogaha, as Vasishtha said. Similarly, Patanjali said in his sutras that yoga chitta vritti nirodhaha. Many people know about these slokas and sutras. So, but ultimately, the yoga scripture says the word meaning of yoga is coming from the word yuj, which means joining, unification. So joining of the individual self with the universal self is called yoga. If we go to a remote village of India, if we ask about yoga, yoga is a Western word, but in India it is pronounced like yog. And the yog very word is came from the mathematical world. In mathematical world, they use yog, means unification, in the form of symbol is called plus. So plus means it is joining. Joining with oneself to another, one subject with another, one number with another. So to join, we need two components. So here, the yoga word is used to join the individual self with the universal self. So yoga is a systematic conscious process to achieve moksha, liberation, mukti. Many people define the aim of yoga in a different way. So let's see how it goes. The application of yoga today, by its practices, we see the application in spiritual world, the sacred knowledge for liberation. We want to liberate ourselves for moksha. We need to go through the yogic text, and which texts are many available. Especially the knowledge part of Vedas is called Upanishad. All the Upanishad, they talks about the universal self and the Paramatman and Brahman in a different language. But the aim is to achieve that, to unite with that supreme soul, with the universal identity. And that is another purpose of yoga. And the process of that, to join, to unify, the process is called yoga. But the practices of yoga in modern world, even in ancient days also, people used to practice yoga for fitness purpose. Now it is in the sports, in gymnasts. There are many yogic practices, many balancing postures which incorporated into sports. So they have also adopted yogic practices. But very uniquely, in recent days, yoga is applied to therapeutic also. Not only very recent days, the therapeutic aspect of yoga, the asana and pranayama and other purification process, whatever we practice in yoga to keep our health all right, it is adopted in Ayurveda also. So yoga is not only for spiritual development, yoga is for total health. And health is not only physical health, as WHO explained, health is a state of well-being at physical, mental, social, and spiritual level, and not merely an absence of illness or infirmity. So just illness is not there, diseases are removed, that means I am healthy. That is not the concept of health, as WHO explained. And in Indian context also, we think about Aragyam, we think about Swastha. These all are the concept to be in ourselves and be healthy, be fit, be free from diseases and move towards wellness. The wellness is the core concept of our Indian system. So Ayurveda, as the knowledge of life in Indian system of medicine, the total Indian system of medicine integrated many practices into it to keep our Ayu, to keep our health all right, to maintain good health and disease-free life by balancing three doshas, as Ayurveda says, Vata, Pitta, Kapha, these doshas to be corrected. So similarly, in yoga also, yoga is the knowledge for life after life, not only in this life, how to rectify our future life. Means in Indian text, Indian philosophy, we believe in rebirth. So birth after birth, our dimension, our goal should be fixed to liberate ourselves. So that's what it takes, janmas after janmas, birth after birth, to achieve that aim of life called liberation or moksha. So in that way, yoga practitioners do their yoga. So to move from illness to wellness and total perfection, on the way we achieve that by balancing three gunas. In Ayurveda we say three doshas. In yoga we say we have to balance our three gunas, sattva, rajas, tamas. If gunas are all right, if gunas are moved from sattva, from tamas to rajas, rajas to sattva, then the person will be healthier, and ultimately a sattvic person will be motivated, or he will be able to achieve the aim of life called moksha or liberation. So yoga, in that way, it is applicable everywhere, and that's what yoga is adopted in all aspects of Indian life. So wellness is the core. So to move in this way, a person has to be healthy, a person has to be all right, sound from everything, from his physical health to the mental health, and till the achievement of moksha. So that's what yogic practices are incorporated in medical practices also. As Ayurveda has adopted yogic practices, there are many practices, asanas, pranayamas, and cleaning techniques, all are incorporated, and it goes hand in hand with yoga and Ayurveda. So there is no difference. We support each other and we try to bring balance in our healthier life. We try to bring balance in our family life. We try to bring balance in our social life. And in this way, we try to take care of total humanity. So in Indian medicine or concept of yoga, we think not the disease, whole man has to be treated. So that's what we need to move from therapeutic aspect to prevention therapy. Prevention is better than cure, as everybody knows. This therapeutic approach or every aspect we move to therapy,
Hello.
This concept
sir,
is...
Sir, sorry for interruption. Your slide is not changing.
Not changing?
Yes. Only welcome slide I am seeing on. Only welcome slide.
Oh, really? Why not changing? Yes. Is it changing now?
Yes, now it is changing.
In this form, is it okay if I go like this?
Yes, sir, yes.
Okay, so I'll go with this only. I think if I make full screen, then it is a problem. So, where I was? Here. So, I was talking about this.
Thank you, sir.
So, in Indian system of medicine, our aim is to treat the person, not the disease. So, whole man has to be treated. So, that's what in Indian context of medicine, we think we should focus into prevention therapy more, then we have to move for further research and development on the therapeutic aspect. Because in a vast populative country like India, to reach this Western system of medicine or Western concept of therapy, it is very difficult. So that's what doctors have limited time, side effects in modern medicine. So all these things we have seen. But somehow, in this duration of corona, we saw that many Ayurveda drugs also we have produced. That is very good achievement. So we are moving from one dimension to another dimension. But we have to keep in mind that we should not follow the Western system of medicine. So our priority should change. Our priority should change to prevention therapy more than the Ayurvedic system, what it is taught in our scripture. And the Western medicine trend is, just I want to mention this word, the trend of Western medicine is to centralize everything and make business out of that. So Ayurveda should not follow that path, what I am suggesting. This is my own view. You may differ with me, but we should reach the system of medication to each man in this world so that it should be available to each and everyone. So that priority should change, and as the modern medicine is doing, Ayurveda should follow our way of life and what we suggest, means Indian context, Indian medicinal concept, we need to promote that. So in yoga, yogic system, we think that yoga, this concept is taken from Yoga Vasishtha. If you read Yoga Vasishtha is another text where it is very nicely explained about yogic concept of disease, removing of disease, all these things. When Rama was under depression, to take out from depression, Rishi Vasishtha was suggesting Rama and explaining all the treatment procedure and our this Vyadhi concept. And there we saw that this Vyadhi or disease, he defined in a nice way. He's saying that this disease can be divided into two parts. One is stress-borne and another is non-stress-borne. non-stress bond means stress is not there, mental agitation is not there, but still we are affected by infections, injuries and toxins and so on, which comes from outside. But another part of disease, discomfort, we face in our day-to-day life, that is stress bond. Stress bond means these all are psychosomatic ailments, means it is starting from the psyche, starting from hypertension, anxiety, depression, IBS, etc. All the diseases you take name, all these diseases are born in the mind. That's what it is called stress bond disease. And this concept we try to promote. And by thinking of this, how the concept of disease yoga is explaining in Taittiriya Upanishad, so it is so nicely explained that the concept of disease, if we understand, we need to understand our existence. So not only this physical body, as modern medicine, modern medical scientists, they are consist, they are stick to the physical body, but the yogic concept, the yoga philosophy went more further and gave this knowledge in Taittiriya Upanishad, which is the basis for yoga therapy, where in Taittiriya Upanishad it is mentioned that our existence is not only the physical body, we have the prana body, which is called pranamaya kosha. So physical body is made of anna, so it is called annamaya kosha. The prana body, the vital energy field, which is called pranamaya kosha. Then we have the manomaya kosha, the thoughts, and these thoughts are divided here in Taittiriya Upanishad into two parts. One is manomaya kosha, another one is vijnanamaya kosha, the intellect, where we discriminate. And another is anandamaya kosha, the blissful existence. So the problem begins, the stress begins in our mind. And the problem starts by conflicting with our mind and the intellect. So buddhi and man, man means here the emotional mind it is talking about. The emotional mind fights with the conflicting with the intellect, and from there the stress begins. And we carry this stress, and this is a huge chapter to explain how these stresses are developed and how to remove the stress. This is another chapter. I think I don't have much time to explain about this. So if we get chance another day, we'll take up this topic. So this stress, it is mentioned in Yoga Vasishta, this stress is nothing but speed. Stress, the yogic definition of stress is speed, vega. The speed is nothing but the speed of thoughts. The thoughts, when these thoughts are agitated, it takes more and more speed, and it goes like anything, and from one thought to another thought, and thoughts are created more and more again and again. And the thing is, we respond to our strong emotions, our likes and dislikes. So the speed is going on in the mind, and in the entire physiology is disturbed by this thought. As you know, when we are agitated, our mind is too much speeded up. At that time, what happened? In Bhagavad Gita, there is a beautiful sloka Lord Krishna has given, and he is telling how the stress is developed and how it disturbs our mind and it kills us at the end. So that's what we need to see, how this is created and how it is disturbed our entire psyche and entire physiology. So when we are agitated, you think about anger. When anger comes to mind and you don't know how to resolve this anger, and due to this development of anger, at the same time we develop breathing faster and faster. When you get angry, you think that I will kill you, I will beat you. All these bad words come from the mouth, and your breath will go faster like anything. And if breathing is faster, then you will see your heartbeat is going faster. If heartbeat is going faster, the entire blood circulation system will be faster like anything. In this situation, inside the physiology, inside the body, it will look like tsunami has come. And at that situation, all the organs in the body, which was working in a harmony, in a rhythm, suddenly they will get disturbed, and they will think that what to do. So at that situation, the way is two. One is fight or flight. So organs, they will be confused. Sometime organ will be overactive to fight the situation, and they will secrete more and more their juices, their acids, their if it is pancreas, it will be insulin, and there will be a overactive situation in the organs. Maybe the organ or the system will think, no, some tsunami has come inside, the circulation is faster, I'm so disturbed, let me see the situation, sit and watch. If the organ is thinking that the sit and watch, then what will happen? In fact, pancreas is thinking that let me see and watch. So the situation is insulin secretion will be stopped. So we'll be in problem. So in this way, we disturb our physical body and our physiology is disturbed. All the organs, all the glands will be disturbed. So the disease takes place after this. So in the body, in the human body, each one of us, we are having some weakest organ in the body, maybe by hereditically or maybe by injury, we have some weakest organ in the body, and that organ will be affected first, and that will be suffering in the form of disease. So that's what the concept of disease comes in yoga, Vasishtha, and that's how we explain. So that's what, how this problem started. We think that the problem started in Manomaya Kosha and Vijnanamaya Kosha, the conflict because of stress, the situation started and it disturbed the whole system. And in our day-to-day life, we know how to take stress. We never learned, even in our education system also, it is never taught that how to deal with stress, how to deal with the mind, and how to deal with our psyche and intellect, everything. But the main problem creator is our mind and intellect. So how to resolve this problem? So in our day-to-day life, all of us, we become Abhimanyu, and we entered into Chakravuha and to fight the stress, but at the end, we kill ourselves. And we must know how to come out from this situation of stress, how to come out from this Chakravuha, and that is all about yogic scripture says. In this way, as yoga explains all the process, and it is focused into mind only, not only mind, there are many other aspects, many other practices to resolve the situation, to relax the body, to strengthen the body and organs, and all the system it is given in yoga therapy, the concept of yoga therapy, that's what it goes like this. When stress develops, the reflection of stress, the disease actually starts in the stage one only, in the mind, and which we don't consider, till today we don't consider that is a disease. Slowly, medical scientists, they have started accepting, you see, yes, the mental problem also a kind of disease. So insomnia, restlessness, irritability, indecisiveness, emotional outburst, anger, anxiety, depression, all kind of problem we face in our day-to-day life, and that is nothing but the stage one disease. And we don't have any solution. We don't have any treatment. Maybe in Ayurveda and Indian medicine, we have much more things to tackle this situation. But in Western concept of medicine, they don't have anything to tackle this situation. So how to take care of this? Yoga gives the answer. So when the stage one disease starts at the Manomaya Kosha in the form of insomnia, restlessness, irritability, etc. So from that time, that is the warning situation in our day-to-day life that we need to take care. And till that, because we don't have the system in our medical system, in the hospitals also, we don't have anything to treat. That's why we don't go to hospital. We try to suppress the situation and the disease aggravate. The next level of this disease is percolates to the Pranamaya Kosha. From Manomaya, it goes to Pranamaya Kosha, and when it goes to Pranamaya Kosha, we feel energy is down, haphazard breathing is observed, the breathing goes very faster. We know breathing should be slower, but in our day-to-day life, when we are most anxious, more stressful, at that time breathing goes very faster. Due to that, the energy is down, tired, fatigue, body pain, these are the feeling we have. we have no energy to work. So in that situation also, we don't know how to take care. Because in our modern medicine, we don't have the technique to revitalize our system. As in Indian medicine, in Ayurveda, in yoga system, we have this technique how to revitalize our system and how to empower our pranamaya kosha. So those practices are incorporated in our medicinal system. So that's what we need to have total approach. And if we don't take care of this manomaya kosha in the beginning, or later, if it is too late, it goes to pranamaya kosha. If then also if it is not taken care, then it will come to the physical body in the form of disease. So it may be muscle stiffness, back pain, joint pain, arthritis, aging will be faster, gastric acidity, ulcer, high BP, IHD, asthma, IBS, diabetes, till cancer. There are many diseases today, we cannot name all these. So that's what, as psychiatric problems in one hand, in other hand, the physical body facing so many suffering. So that's what, and throughout the life, as we don't have the solution, and we don't know the approach, how to take out this problem, how to resolve the stress, how to deal with these root causes of diseases, and because of this ignorance, we end our life with suffering. So till the end of the life, we take plenty of medicines and we suffer like anything. That's what in yoga therapy, we suggest for the physical body, for each component, as I explained in our panchakosha, in our five sheets body, for physical body, we should have proper diet, we should have kriyas, we should clean our body. Kriyas are in Ayurveda, it is shatkarma. So how to clean our body from our eyes or brain till the anus internally. So entire cleaning system, so nicely it is explained in our text, we cannot imagine. If we clean our system, then we'll see how the body is in progress, how we are removing the disease from the physical body. So from physical body, we can clean this kind of toxins, this kind of problems, this kind of suffering from the organs and the muscles, and we can be all right physically. But physically all right is not the goal of yogic or Indian medicinal system. We need to be healthier and healthier more and more, because our aim is to move towards wellness, not only removing the illness. So like this, we have Trataka to clean our brain, frontal brain, to clean our nose, to clean our eyes. These are the system we have in our Shatkarmas and Shatkriyas. So there, in the vital energy body, in yoga, we have several practices to take care of our vital energy. Directly, we can approach our pranamaya kosha to rectify those negativities, those problems. In pranamaya kosha, we have different kind of practices of pranayama. We know there are plenty of pranayama practices. Among those, we practice mainly breathing techniques. Those are not actually called pranayama. Pranayama is different. To practice pranayama, we should have a feeling of prana. Till we feel the prana, we cannot practice pranayama. Till that time, it is only breathing technique. Whatever practice we do by holding our nose, it is the breathing technique. But from breathing technique to move towards pranayama, it takes time, and it takes long time to feel the essence of prana and to channelize those pranas which is flowing internally. So there are many several pranayamas like that to rectify our pranas. And today there are many practices and there are research going on how to rectify our pranamaya kosha by several practices. And if auras or pranas are rectified, then diseases are removed from pranamaya kosha only, so that it will not percolate to the physical body if it is taken care from pranamaya kosha only. So it takes time to percolate till the physical body. So we have MSRT, mind sound resonance techniques in yoga. We have PET called pranic energizing technique, which is beautiful techniques. We give this practices to cancer patients, arthritis patients, and we benefit like anything. We have pranic healing, another system, although the system came from Japan and other places. So that also has given many results through pranic healing also. Direct prana energy is taken care. They are also into research, developing more and more. But in our traditional practices, it is given, there are pranayama practices. By that only we can rectify our pranas. So because of physical body is suffering and pranamaya kosha, we need to take care to do all this pranayama. We need to clean our nasal passages so that in Shatkarma also, there are neti dhoti, there are several techniques. For nasal passages, we have netis, sutra neti or jala neti, budhkarma, sutkarma. There are several techniques to clean our nasal passages and to keep our nasal passage strengthened and all right. That's what we give these practices. These are the preliminary practices to go for yoga practices. Before that, we must practice and learn these techniques. So these are unique techniques to keep ourselves fit and all right. And for Manomaya Kosha, we have Dharana Dhyana and emotion culture. Dharana is focusing from several thoughts, from Chanchalata, from many puzzle thoughts. From there, we try to concentrate in one point, and from there, we move towards Dharana, from Dharana to Dhyana. These are the process in Rajajaga, it is explained. And if that is practiced, then these stress thoughts are removed, mind will be calm and quiet. As Patanjali said, Chogus Chitta Vritti Nirodha, to Nirodha all these vrittis, it is very much helpful. That's what Dhyana is the most effective practice, and we think that at the end of all yogic practices, we reach this state of mind called Dhyana. And from there, we move towards Samadhi. And Samadhi is not the end of yogic practices. We say Samadhi is the beginning of yogic practices. So to take care of Manomaya Kosha, if Manomaya Kosha is clean, if intellects are clean, then there is no disease. We will move towards wellness. Because the disease starts at Manomaya Kosha in the Vijnanamaya Kosha conflict. So that if that is clean, then slowly all this other aspect of life, existence, like Pranamaya Kosha and the Annamaya Kosha, the physical body, it will be cleaned automatically, and the mind and the physical body will be calm and quiet. So not only this Manomaya Kosha, for yoga therapy methods, for Vijnanamaya Kosha, the intellect, we have practices called yogic counseling. This counseling method is little different from so-called counseling technique by Western philosophers. This counseling techniques will talk about karma yoga. It will talk about how to deal our life in our day-to-day situation, and how to correct our problems, how to analyze our happiness, because happiness disorder will take place. So why happiness is not there? Why ananda is not there in life? That need to analyze. So that analysis takes place, and the basis of this analysis are Yoga Vasishtha, Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is a unique text. We consider it as a sacred text, as a holy book, but we consider this is a most scientific and technical book to tackle the mind, to tackle the life in day-to-day life. And not only day-to-day life, what happens after this life, all these things talks very nicely. The essence of all yogic thought is given in Bhagavad Gita. So it is very much technical and very much scientific. In this way, another point was there, that is called Anandamaya Kosha. For Anandamaya Kosha, the practices are given like Karma Yoga. Karma Yoga is the Nishwat Bhav Se Kaam Karna, in selfless service to the nation, to the humanity, not for me, for others. This is the concept in Karma Yoga. It is given, the karmanne vadhikaraste mahaphaleshu kadachana, we say. So we have to stick to our action, we have to stick to our duties, not to the fruit or action, result of the action. So that is the essence of Karma Yoga. If we work in that dimension, then I think we will be more successful in our day-to-day life also. At the same time, our mind also will be stress-free. So happy assembly, get together, action and bliss. These are the concept it is taken in Anandamaya Kosha exercise. So this is a kind of therapeutic module I explained to you. So in this way, we need to take care of our entire existence, our physical body. So that's what this research-based integrated approach of yoga therapy, we say this is the integrated approach. Because why it is integrated? Because we are not taking care only the physical body. We are taking care of our entire existence, the five layer of existence from our physical body to Ananda. These are the levels, the existence, and we need to reduce the speed. We need to reduce the stress from each and every levels. Then only we can move from illness to wellness. And wellness is a concept where there will be no suffering. There will be no pain in the physical body and in the mental body. So that's what in the yoga dunya, in the yoga world, we are trying to practice many, many yogic techniques, which is explained in our yogic text. Many people are unknown about this. People think that yoga means only asanas and pranayamas. No. If you go through Bhagavad Gita, what you will see Bhagavad Gita? From the beginning, the first chapter itself, it is said, Arjuna Vishada Yogaha. Arjuna's Vishad means Arjuna was under depression. And that depression also can be converted into yoga. That's what the message by Lord Krishna, it is given in Bhagavad Gita. So each and every chapter is considered as yoga. In the war field, he was teaching yoga. So unique it is. And how to come out from this situation, how to come out from this turmoil of duty and conflict between lower dharma and higher dharma, these are the conflict resolution and stress related problem. And all these problems create in our life, that solution is given there. So that's what it is, a unique text, Bhagavad Gita, that should be followed by everyone. So that's what this concept, all this concept of wellness and to be free from suffering are all yogic texts. They explain about that. There are many research has been done at Ajvesa Yoga University. There we saw the reduction of stress level compared to sleep. Usually after sleep only, after 6 hours of sleep, we reduce our stress and you revitalize our system to work next day. There we saw only 35 minutes of one package of practice called SMET, SMET, self-management of excessive tension. We have a 35 minutes protocol to follow. There we saw 32% reduction in the BMR. Compared to Transcendental Meditation, TM, they practice 20 minutes of TM and they could reduce 15% at the end. And in the sleep, it is not given here, it is 23%. After 6 hours of sleep, we could reduce 23% of this basal metabolic rate, the stress symptom, whatever it was, assessed at that time. If we go through Ajvesa research, we will get that. So there are plenty of research protocol we followed at Ajvesa, and it has given tremendous result. There are, after IAYT program, IAYT means what we give in our 7 days protocol in the Arogya Dhamma, where patient comes and stay there for 7 days, and we give there the complete package of this lifestyle meditation, lifestyle medicine, the yogic therapy technique. There you saw the people reducing their medication, their pain is reduced. All these measurement parameters we have taken at the end in 2 weeks of program, we saw tremendous result of reduction of everything, reduction of medication, reduction of stress, all these things, it is assessed and it is given in our journals also. There are plenty of medical journals there. We have published our papers on yoga therapy. So that must be assessed. This is one of my own research on hypertension. There also I saw tremendous reduction in 2 weeks. We cannot imagine, the blood pressure can be reduced. Medication can be reduced. Those who are going through the hypertension medicine. So there are many people, even Deepak Chopra also, he has written a book on this. So we must read all these things, how yoga only can take care of medicine. Then our Indian system of medicine, Ayurveda, is there again. So if we combine all the system and protocol in yogic lifestyle and our Indian lifestyle, what it is explained in our shastras and in our scriptures, if we follow and if we develop in a systematic way the Indian medicine system and the yogic system parallelly, so we can see the miracle. Not only this suffering in this life, we can remove our suffering from next life also. That's what yogic texts are explaining. This is unique. Really, it is amazing in Indian system of medicine and Indian system of healthy living, wellness is promoted, and that must be followed by each and every one of us. Not only that, throughout the globe, this going to follow. As we know, the International Day of Yoga ahead, it is on 21st. So whole world is accepted yoga. And slowly, after Corona also, during Corona also, we see how the demand of Ayurvedic medicine and Ayurvedic protocol is throughout the world, they are demanding. Because something is there without side effects, without hazards. So for a long life, for a healthy life, for a happy life, people are searching the way, and the way is here. The treasure house of knowledge for health and happiness and medicine, that is in India, it is lying in India. I think the future research need more research in Ayurveda and yoga combinedly, and we can see the world will sunshine like anything by the light of yoga and Ayurveda, and it will lead the humanity to lead a healthy life, and the lifestyle disease, lifestyle disorder, it will be gone, and the whole world will be peaceful. This is the greatest message given by yoga, Ayurveda, and all the systems of Indian medicine. It is very clear message is given that to come out from this suffering, we need to change our lifestyle, we need to change our thinking protocol, we need to change our habits and be with nature. Then only nature will take care of us. So hope this International Day of Yoga, all the students, all the people throughout the globe, they will be adopting yoga and Ayurveda as their way of life, from eating to sleeping. All the things are explained in our text that can be followed, and it will be more and more popular throughout the world. And hope I also can be one of the part of this mission, and all the Ayurvedic students and yogic students will go hand in hand to make this happen, and India also will sunshine with this concept of health, and we are going to lead. The yoga, Ayurveda is going to lead the world to become more and more healthier with this concept and thought. I am going to conclude my speech. If any questions for 5 minutes, I can take. Thank you very much. Thanks to NIA for giving me this opportunity to talk before you. Hope near future I will be more closer to you, and it will be my pleasure if I can visit the modern Nalanda of India, NIA. So I am waiting for the day. Thank you very much. Thank you, organizers, and thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for such a wonderful talk, a scientific approach towards the yoga therapy. Thank you so much. And now I would like to invite the queries, if any. They can participants can ask their questions. If you have any query, please ask. I think, sir, there is no question.
I think because so all of them mostly
personally,
there.
Personally, I would like
yoga.
To think.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Actually, these are the students of yoga.
Yeah, that's what they know. Most of the points what I explained. Okay, very good.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. But some in every lecture there is something new. ये मेरा ओपिनियन है सर कि हमको कुछ ना कुछ नया मिलता ही है.
What is
कितना
new
भी
in
पढ़े
this?
कुछ ना कुछ नया मिलता है.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, correct.
सर जैसे आपने एक लाइन बोली समाधि इज नॉट द एंड ऑफ योगा, समाधि इज बिगनिंग ऑफ योगा.
तो दैट वर्ड
मेरे लिए तो ये सही लाइन थी सर.
करेक्ट करेक्ट.
बहुत अच्छा प्रेजेंटेशन था सर.
थैंक यू वेरी मच.
व्यक्तिगत रूप से मैं आपको धन्यवाद देती हूँ और ऑफिशियल वर्ड थैंक्स के लिए मैं डॉक्टर पुनीत चतुर्वेदी को इनवाइट करती हूँ. डॉक्टर पुनीत
जी सर. सर नमस्ते सर.
नमस्ते
सर. मैं स्वस्थ्रत परिवार की ओर से आपका हार्दिक धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूँ कि आपने अपने अमूल्य समय में से कुछ समय हमको दिया. इसके साथ साथ मैं धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूँ अपने सभी विद्यार्थियों का जिनके सहयोग से ये कार्यक्रम पूरा हो पाया. सभी गुरुजन जिनके मार्गदर्शन से ये कार्यक्रम पूरा हो पाया उनके प्रति मैं अपनी कृतज्ञता ज्ञापित करता हूँ. इसके साथ साथ हमारे पूर्व विभागाध्यक्ष प्रोफेसर कमलेश शर्मा भी इस प्रोग्राम से जुड़े रहे, उनके प्रति भी अपना धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूँ. सर जैसा कि मेडिटेशन का जो अर्थ है वो सिर्फ ब्रेथ का अवेयरनेस ही नहीं है. जब एक माता पुत्र को अपने सीने से लगाती है तो वो भी उसके लिए मेडिटेशन का इफेक्ट करता है क्योंकि उसकी सारी चिंता विषाद सारी चीजें दूर हो जाती है. उसी तरह से ही जब एक ऐसे वक्ता का हमको सानिध्य मिले तो श्रोताओं के मन के सारे द्वंद्व दूर हो जाते हैं. तो वैसा ही जो इफेक्ट है आज आपके ज्ञान के गंगा के प्रवाह के कारण हमको देखने को मिला. तो सर इसके लिए मैं आपका बेहद धन्यवाद ज्ञापित करता हूँ और आशा करता हूँ भविष्य में आपको हमको प्रत्यक्ष भी यहाँ पे ज्ञान का प्रवाह लेने का अनुभव मिलेगा. तो इसके लिए सर मैं आपका बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद देता हूँ. और दुर्गावती मैडम से निवेदन करूंगा कि हमारा एक छोटी सी सूचना है ऑनलाइन योगा कंपटीशन से रिलेटेड, तो वो सर वो आप सभी के समक्ष प्रस्तुत करें मैडम.
थैंक यू वेरी मच.
दुर्गावती मैडम
आ रही है
जी. मैडम आवाज आ रही है.
आ रही है सब लोगों के लिए. राष्ट्रीय योग दिवस के में हम ऑनलाइन वीडियो कंपटीशन ऑर्गेनाइज कर रहे हैं और ये स्टूडेंट्स के लिए है बेसिकली. इस स्टूडेंट्स में बाद में फिर मेरिट बेस पर फर्स्ट सेकेंड और थर्ड प्राइज भी दिए जाएंगे. तो मेरा जो है अनुरोध है सभी लोगों से कि सारे स्टूडेंट्स ज्यादा से ज्यादा में इसमें पार्टिसिपेट करें और अपने परिवार के साथ भी और स्वयं के साथ भी. एक्चुअली इसमें दो कैटेगरीज हैं, सोलो एक विद फैमिली. तो सोलो और दोनों इसमें सॉरी दोनों ही कैटेगरीज में आप लोग पार्टिसिपेट करें और इस प्रोग्राम को सक्सेसफुल बनाएं. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
इसके साथ ही अब मैं इस सेशन की समाप्ति की घोषणा करती हूँ. थैंक यू सो मच. सभी लोगों का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.